So, I did it. I pre-ordered the Canon 1DX Mark III, which is coming in on Monday, and by the time you guys see this video, I will have it in my hands, which is exciting, super exciting for me. It's a crazy $6,500 camera that has got some incredible video specs. It can shoot 5.5K RAW, it shoots DCI and UHD 10-bit 4K up to 60 frames per second, 1080p up to 120 frames per second. It's got C-Log, it's got focus peaking, it's got focus guide, and it's got the dual pixel autofocus. It's finally got a better recording codec than the Motion JPEG that was on the 1DX Mark II. It's a full frame camera just like my EOS R, which is what I'm filming on right now, and I'll be doing a comparison video between these two cameras at a later point, so make sure you subscribe to this channel to see when that video drops. Now on paper, this is an incredible camera and I can't wait to get my hands on it and play around with it, but I'm gonna tell you right off the bat that this is not the camera for me. I'm not gonna be keeping this camera, and let me tell you why. So if you don't know already, what I mainly do is wedding videography and I make commercials as well. Most of the time I'm shooting on gimbals, which is what I find to create some really cinematic footage and what helps me make the best videos that I can. And usually I'm shooting for very long times for lots of consecutive hours like on weddings. And the 1DX Mark III is an incredibly heavy camera. It's gonna be weighing in at 3.5 pounds with the battery and the lens attached to it. And so once you put that onto a gimbal, and I have a ton of accessories attached onto the gimbal itself, it's gonna be really hard for me to operate it for longer periods of time. When I'm shooting on the EOS R, it's definitely a lighter camera and lighter setup. So the 1DX Mark III is definitely gonna tire me out a lot faster, which is one of the reasons why I didn't get the 1DX Mark II. Another huge reason why I think that I'm not gonna keep the 1DX Mark III is because there is no flip out screen like the one I'm looking at right on my EOS R. Now, I own the Canon 5D Mark IV and now the EOS R, and then way before that was the Panasonic GH4, which is this camera right there. 99% of the time, I'm using my EOS R to shoot video because it's so much easier to see what I'm shooting with this flip out screen. I know for photographers, you guys have that little, what is it, the eyepiece thing? The thing that you put to your eye and then you just shoot and stuff like that. For video, it's a lot different. You don't shoot it through the thing. We like looking at the screen to see exactly what we're shooting. And on the 5D, you have to get into like really awkward positions just to like see the LCD screen. If your camera is a little bit lower, then you have to like look at it from like down here, and it's like, it's super awkward and it's super inconvenient for me to shoot with, and that's why I like the EOS R. Now, of course, you can use like an external monitor. I've used that before, but with the 1DX, since it's already so heavy, it's gonna add on extra weight to something that I don't really want to add on extra weight to. And lastly, the price. For $6,500, it's a lot of money to spend on a single piece of gear, not to mention like, you know, the Reds and all these other cinema cameras. Those are expensive as well, but for like a DSLR, for what we do, $6,500 is a lot of money. And I don't think that it's worth it for me to spend that much money on specs that I don't necessarily need. I've never shot a commercial or even a wedding film and then looked back at it and then thought, you know what would have made this incredible and look so much better? If we shot RAW. Or if we shot 4K 10-bit. Or if I shot the entire thing in 120 frames per second. These are just not things I think of when I look back on past films. Things like composition, things like lighting, storytelling, editing. These are the things that make my films a lot better than things I could improve on, not just specs on a camera. For what I do, the EOS R is already a perfect camera. Yes, 4K 60 frames would have been nice. 120 frames per second would have been nice, but it's definitely not needed. However, these are just my predictions on what I think I will feel about the camera. Once I get a chance to play around with the camera, let's see how I feel about it. Who knows? I might just keep it. Maybe not. But maybe I might. Nah. Definitely not. What do you guys think? Would you get the 1DX Mark III? Is it something that you're interested in? Leave a comment down below. Also, I am gonna be making a ton of videos about the 1DX Mark III. I really wanna put it through its paces. And so if you are interested at all, make sure you come back to this channel or subscribe. That'll be even easier. Let me know what kind of videos you guys would like to see in the comments down below. Leave everything down there. But that's it for this video. If you guys liked it, please hit that like button. Make sure to subscribe. Hit the bell to get notified of every video that I post. My name is Alex Chung, and I'll see you later. Bye!